Automobile is too, is edging ever so slightly closer towards its final form, which should be released in the next few weeks. However, as of now, AMS2 sits at version 0.9.1 and therefore received more content, an interesting new feature, and also a fully reworked netcode for its multiplayer, which will all be covered in this video. But as always, if you're interested in the full changelog, there'll be a link in the description. Anyway, starting off, Rezo stood by the words and added the Brazilian endurance prototype, the Sigma P1. Funnily enough though, this very car is featured in the P2 class, as its overall weight, especially considering the drivetrain, made the car too heavy to compete against other P1 cars and was only classified as a P2 car. Fun facts aside though, the Kuala Lumpur circuit in South Africa was updated to its current Grand Prix layout, which means its old default layout is now available under the name Kuala Lumpur Historic 1976. Next on, the multiplayer, or rather its netcode, had to undergo intense investigations as of last patch, which finally led to Rezo identifying some issues and straight up fixing them. This should from now on make online races more enjoyable, as it is now possible to race each other a lot closer than before, as in older versions of AMS2, one was more or less forced to leave at least a half a meter safety gap to other cars in order to not spin them, or even worse, yourself round and end at least one race predominantly. This change actually brought me to race in some multiplayer sessions again, after this very issue made me avoid online races as much as possible, since they were not exactly fun, but rather a gamble whether the netcode was in your favor or not. And from my newly gathered experiences, I can safely say that the netcode actually seems to be working properly now, most of the time, where you're almost guaranteed to be safe, as long as you're not racing someone with 200 ping or more. Lastly, let's take a look at one entirely new feature and one very welcoming adjustment. The new feature is rather self-explanatory, with it being a nice utilization of the Mendes engine's capabilities, as it's able to simulate how a track behaves in real time regarding temperatures and grip levels. So basically, Rezo made use of this very feature and adapted it in a way that there is now less grip if you leave the racing line. The grip loss can definitely be felt, but only if you really look out for it. Otherwise, you'll probably not notice too much of a difference. Secondly, the amount which your car bounces after you go off track and drive over grass or gravel has been reduced a bit, which is definitely a step in the right direction, as going off track felt more like riding a roller coaster and actually made me feel dizzy to the point where I needed to take a break from AMS2, which I only experienced in racing in VR so far. Actually, I'd really appreciate a separate setting that reduces the camera's shakiness when driving over bumpy surfaces even further, as it is still rather intense to me. Anyway, these are basically all the more important changes for this update. Now, if you want to be informed about future updates and what they change, or more sim racing content in general, be sure to hit that subscribe button in order to not miss anything. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!